Hi guys, welcome back to the Surf Simply Resort. We are on episode 2 of our exploration of some of the iconic surfboards, the replicas that we have in the rooms here at the resort. We have moved from the Bob Simmons Spoon in 1949 through to the Dale Velzy Pig in 1955. So let's dive into some of the design features and get to know the history of the board. The 1950s began a new age in surfing. The days of heavy boards and limited maneuverability were numbered, and the subject of this week's episode of Surfboard Icons perhaps hit the first nail into an aging surf style coffin. The revolutionary Pig model, designed by Dale Velzy in 1955, was an important development of the decade, and it changed the way surfers rode a wave. Born and raised in Hermosa Beach, California, Dale Velzy started surfing at the age of 10, and not long after, in fact at the age of 11, was shaping his own surfboards. Velzy is credited not only with giving birth to the Pig model, but also for the way in which he expanded the concept of surfboard making, by turning it from a largely DIY activity into an industry. With the Pig, Dale Velzy reversed the traditional outline shape of the board, practically flipping the board back to front. The design, constructed from 100% balsa and laminated with fiberglass, was around 10 feet long, weighed somewhere between 20 and 30 pounds, and featured a wide and blunt tail with a relatively narrow nose. This allowed for faster turns and better maneuverability, fitting in to different sections of the wave. The main design difference between the Pig and its predecessors was its curved rail line. The pulled-in nose and the board's wide point being brought back towards the tail, combined with an oversized skeg or fin, placed right at the tail block, made it incredibly easy to pivot. So now, surfers could use the board to go up and down the wave face and cut back towards the whitewater, significantly increasing the maneuverability and responsiveness of the board on the wave instead of just positioning and angling down the line. The Pig design also featured softer and more curved rails, and Velzy surfboards had a particularly good reputation for high-quality shaping and glassing. With all of this combined, led to them becoming the surfboard of the moment in 1950s California. With Velzy's commercial approach to surfboard making, when in 1949 he opened Velzy Surfboards, it was considered to be the first surf shop ever. He later expanded his surf shops to more surf-centric communities in California and Hawaii. And although he had great success, in 1959 his empire of shops was shut by the IRS, and Dale Velzy was charged with tax evasion. So despite burning brightly, but only briefly, Dale Velzy's contributions to surfboard design remain significant some 65 years later. Dale continued to be an influential figure within the surf industry right up until his death in 2005, and he'll continue to be celebrated as a trailblazer by the surf community. So, once again, thank you, Dale, for your contribution.
Well, guys, thanks for joining us this week. I hope you enjoyed this episode. We'll see you next week for something similar. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for all the coaching content and surfboard design content that we put out there. Say hi to us in the comments or put a question there if you have something you want to ask. And we'll see you next time. Bye, guys.